to a yet another session on fields. So today's session is a very important session. So in this session we will discuss with the governing differential equation for the fin. So the proper understanding of this equation is very much essential for the solving the numericals, right? So today we will start with the derivation. So consider this a wall, right? On this wall, we have attached a rectangular fin like this. So this is the fin which is attached on the wall. Now assume that the wall, it is at a higher temperature. The wall is hot. So let the temperature of the wall be TO and let the surrounding temperature be TA. So here you should keep this in mind that the wall is at a higher temperature as compared to the surrounding temperature. So now we will focus on the fin. So this is our rectangular fin. So the length of the fin, it is given as L, the width is B, and the thickness is delta. So this is the geometrical specification of the fin. Now what is happening? Whatever the heat which is there from the wall, it is coming into this fin. Okay, here it is mentioned. See, this is the Q. So this heat, it is entering, and due to this, what is happening? That this wall is getting, the temperature is reduced quickly, or the heat is dissipated fast. So now here we will find the temperature distribution equation first, because for designing the fin, the temperature distribution along the fin should be very much clear to us. So this is the introductory part of the diagram. Now let's move on to the derivation. So before going to the derivation, there should be some points that should be very much clear to you. And these are the assumptions that we make. So the first assumption is that the heat is conducted in one dimensional only. So here we're taking that the problem is nothing but the one dimensional problem. So this is nothing but, here you can see, you can consider, take this as the one dimensional problem, that is in particular x direction. Next, very important, is nothing but the steady state, right? Third, uniform edge over the entire fin surface. Now this fin, it is exposed to the environmental condition. So the value of h, it is not changing throughout, it's constant, we are assuming. Next assumption is that there is no heat generation within the fin. In this fin, there is no heat generation. Fifth assumption is that the value of k, that is of the fin material, is constant throughout, it is not changing. And last, the contact resistance, here the contact resistance which is there is also taken into consideration, but it is very negligible, so we are neglecting it. One more assumption is there, we have missed it out, that radiation is not taken into consideration here, because if we take radiation into consideration, the analysis will become more difficult. So for time being, we are neglecting it, right? So now let's move on to the derivation part. So now consider this dotted portion. I have considered this as the small elemental section of the fin, right? So let it be at a distance x from the wall. Okay, this it be at a distance x from the wall, and let the thickness or the width is nothing but tx. Sorry, the length of the fin is nothing but tx. So just this is the one-dimensional view of the fin. So let consider this dotted line, this elemental section of the fin, let the length be dx, let it be located at a distance x from the wall, right? So this is the fin. So what is happening? The heat is entering from the wall into the fin. So let the heat which is entering be qx. Some heat will go out, that is nothing but qx plus tx. And some heat, now the area is exposed over here to convection, I have shown with the arrow. So this is nothing but convection. So you can find a zoomed view of this in this section over here. Now what is happening here, you can see that the temperature distribution is there. Okay, so this is the graph of temperature versus the distance. So initially at the base of the fin, the temperature of the fin will be nothing but the temperature of the base. So as we move in the direction of the fin, okay, in this x direction, what will happen? The temperature, it will reduce gradually, and after some time it will attain the temperature of the surrounding, that is nothing but TA, right? So now we will focus on the derivation part. So I hope the physical part, that is the geometrical part, is very much clear to you. Okay, so now what is entering into this element, we will focus here only now. Okay, so this is our focus now. So what is entering into the element now? Qx amount of heat is it entering into the element. So how this heat is entering? This heat is entering by conduction. Whatever the heat of the wall, this heat moves in the x direction. It moves in the x direction. So what we can write? The heat entering into the element is nothing but Qx. So as per the Fourier's law, how can I write? Qx is as minus Ka dty dx. So name this equation number one, right? Now the heat entering is Qx. What is going out from the elemental volume, element dx? Qx plus ds. This much amount of heat, it is going out from the element. So I will write down. Heat conducted out from the element at x plus dx is what? Qx plus dx. So from the fundamental principles of derivation, I can write this Qx plus dx as Qx, this much heat will be there, plus dy dx of Qx with respect to this distance x. So if I put the values of Qx over here, you know the value of Qx as minus Ka dty dx plus dy dx of Qx. If I substitute the value of Qx again, I will get the plus sign is replaced by minus sign, and Ka, it is nothing but the constant over here. So d square t by dx square into dx. So this is the equation 2, that is nothing but the heat which is conducted out of the element, right? Now what is happening? So these are the two parts. First is some heat is coming, some heat is going out. There is one more part through which the heat is going out, and the heat is going out through what? Convection. Now we will see the energy balance. That is the most important. So before this, let's just go back to the previous page. Now how much amount of heat is, I will just explain you with some numerical values. That will be very much easy for you to understand. For example, assume that 100 watts of heat, it is entering into this small element dx. So entering is 100. Out of this, some heat is conducted out. So let the conduction that is conducted out be 70. So where is 30 now? So 30 amount of heat, that is 30 watt of heat, will be convected from the surface of the fan. So this is nothing but the energy balance. So now what we will do, we will apply the energy balance equation. So what is entering? 100 watt it is entering through conduction. How much it is going out? Going out is by two things. One is conduction, another one is by convection. So how much is going out? 70 by conduction. See here, 70 it is going out by conduction, and this 30 it is going into the surrounding by convection. So the energy balance becomes 100, that is equal to 70 plus 30, means whatever is coming, that is going out. So now here you need to focus that this is the heat is liberated by convection in throughout the surface. So hence for convection, you should take into consideration the surface area. And for conduction, you should take into consideration the cross-sectional area. This is a very important point. I am just repeating it again. For Fourier's law, always we take the cross-sectional area. And for the convection, we always take the surface area. That's why we are writing the equation for convection in terms of this perimeter. See, the formula for convection is Q is equal to HA delta T. So we are replacing this A by P into dx, because we in terms of perimeter we are writing. So this is the energy balance. Heat conducted into the element, that is equal to heat conducted out plus heat convected out. So I hope this is clear. Now what is conducted? We know by the Fourier's law, minus Ka dty dx, that is equal to how much it is conducted out, here you can write from the equation. See, this is conducted, okay, and lastly this is nothing but this is convected out. So now what we will do, we will do the mathematical arrangement. So this and this, it gets cancelled. So what you are left with, 0, that is equal to minus ka d square t by dx square plus h p, p is nothing but your perimeter, multiplied by dx into t minus ta. Now what is this t? T is nothing but the temperature at the location dx, okay. So upon rearranging this equation, you will get a equation like this, d square t by dx square minus hp upon ka into t minus ta, okay. So now I hope till this the equation is very much clear. Now what we will do, we will substitute theta for this t minus ta, okay. So for this t minus ta, we will substitute the as theta, and it is called as excess temperature. So now let's differentiate this equation number 5, okay. So if you differentiate with respect to x, you get d theta by dx, that is equal to dt minus, sorry, dt divided by dx, okay. Here it should be ta. Ta, it is nothing but the ambient temperature, that is constant, and we are not taking into consideration. So if we differentiate, we get d theta by dx, that is equal to dt by dx. Now we will again differentiate this equation. So what we get, d square theta by dx square, that is equal to d square t by dx square, okay. So this one term we have introduced, theta, that is called as excess temperature. Now we will introduce one more constant, that is nothing but m, okay, that is nothing but under root hp upon kac. So this is, we don't need to think too much what is this m and all, so we have taken it for our purpose, okay. So m is equal to under root hp upon kac. Now what we will do, we will substitute the value of equation 6 and 7 in equation number 4, okay, just pay attention, very easy. So what we will do, d square t by dx square, what is this? Here we will replace d square t by dx square with what? D square theta by dx square, and for hp upon kac I will write m square, and this t minus ta I will replace it by theta, okay. So after doing the necessary substitutions, I get a equation d square theta by dx square minus m square theta, that is equal to 0, clear. Now this is the second order differential equation, okay. So this is the second order differential equation. Now the solution of this second order differential equation is given by this equation, okay. Theta is equal to c1 e to the power mx plus c2 e to the power minus mx. You don't need to go to the derivation of this equation. Just keep this in mind that the solution is given by theta is equal to c1 e to the power mx plus c2 e to the power minus mx. Right? This is the solution of this second order differential equation. Now what does this equation, second order differential equation, what information does it give? It gives the temperature distribution along the fin. So it represents the temperature distribution along the fin, and this is very much important while designing a fin, because one should have a clear understanding or knowledge about how will be the temperature distribution along the fin. So this knowledge is used while designing the fins. So now we have got the solution to the second order differential equation. So just directly keep this in mind, don't take tension how it has come and all, right. Now here c1 and c2 are nothing but the constant. So how will you determine c1 and c2? Again the same case, by applying the boundary conditions. So for determining the value of c1 and c2, we will have to take or consider these three cases. Case number one, that is nothing but heat dissipation from a long fin. Second, long fin with insulated tip, and again the last case is nothing but a short fin. So now we will be utilizing this equation again and again, this equation number 9, to find the value of C1 and C2, and accordingly we will find the value of Q by applying the concept to these 3 cases. Okay, so we will have a separate video on each of the following cases. So till then, keep watching Happy Learning. Thank you.